Good morning, students. So previous class we will discuss about climate and adaptation. You know, so what is that meaning of that adaptation? That means the presence of specific features or certain habits which enable to plants and animals to live in surrounding. You know, adaptation means that particular animals, okay, it can survive in that particular area. Why that animal it can survive in that area means because that animal it can adapt in that conditions. So that's why that animal it can survive that regions. Now today we are going to discuss about the polar regions. You know that polar regions, you know the polar regions like the North Pole and South Pole, you know. So North Pole and South Pole is always extreme cold climate. These regions is also covered with snow and is very cold for most part of the year. You know, the whole year the poles is always covered snow as well as is very cold. In this region, for 6 months the sun does not set at the poles, while for the 1/6 month the sun does not rise. So here the 6 month sun does not set. And another 6 months sun does not rise because the climate conditions. Because of the climate conditions, here the winter the temperature can be is very low, -37°C. You know, it's very very cold regions. You know, so the polar region, it is very important. One more question: the polar region temperature -37°C. So such kinds of animal only it can survive in that regions. You know, all animals cannot survive in that regions. Already told you, you know, one word, that adaptations. You know, so those animal it can survive in these conditions, like that polar bear and penguin. Also the some kinds of animal it can survive or live in these polar regions. So now we will discuss about the how can the polar bear it can survive in that region. So the polar bear have white fur, so it's they are not easily visible in that snow. You know, the polar bear skin, you know, like look like in the white fur, like the hair like structure, you know, white fur, they are not easily visible in that snow white background. It protect them from the predators. You know, the predator, it protect them from predators. It's also help them in catching their prey. To protect them from extreme cold, they have two thick layer of fur. So the polar bears naturally having the thick fur. Okay, so the polar bear having the two thick layer of fur is very important. Two thick layer of fur. Okay, they also have a layer of fat under the skin. You know, fat is deposited under the skin. Okay, mom. So that's why what will happen, the polar bear is can survive in that polar regions, because the polar bear having that two layer of thick fur, and under the fur it deposited on the fat. Okay, so that's why the polar bear it can survive in that conditions. You know, in fact they are so well insulated that they have to move slowly and rest often to avoid getting the overheated. So that polar bear it can survive in the polar regions only. And physical activities of warm days, you know, the physical activities of warm days necessity cooling. So the polar bear goes for swimming. It good swimmer. Its paws and wide and large, which help to not only to swim well but also walk that easy in that snow. You know, Because you know one thing, the snow it always walk on the snow regions because that body it can adopt it. The body it can adopt it in that situation. While swimming under the water, it can close its nostrils and can remain underwater for long durations. It has a strong sense of smell so that it can catch its prey for food. So this polar bear, it can live in the polar region. The polar bear having the good smelling character, so that's why this polar bear it can catch its prey for food. We can understand that adaptation of polar bear with the help of the flow chart figure 7.3. You know, look at the picture. So this the first, you know, the white fur is not easily visible in the snow white background because so this polar bear having that white fur. So it is a it one of the adaptations. Okay, wow. So the polar bear having this adaptation, so that's why the polar bear it can live and survive in that conditions. Okay, and second point, it has a very strong sense of smell. So the polar bear naturally having the good smelling character. Okay, wow. So that's why it can easy to catch the prey for food, and it helps the bear to locate and catch its prey. It has long curved and sharp claws like the nail regions, you know, it has a very long and sharp. This helps it to walk on ice, okay, because of the foot, you know, like padam, you know. So it's very soft and having that long areas. So that's why the polar bear it can easy to walk on that regions. And it has a layer of fat under the skin. Already told, you know, the polar bear having that white fur, you know. So the fat substances is deposited on under the skin. So that's why polar bear can easy to survive in that polar regions. And next one, the fat insulated its body from cold and kept in warm. So it insulate its body from cold and kept in warm. And the cold and the konjam warm a irukkaradhukku adu use agudhu. Okay, va idu fat. The fat insulate its body from cold and keeps it warm. This keeps it warm in cold weather. Okay, va. So that's why the polar bear it can live in that polar regions. So it has two thick layer of fur. So that naturally the polar bear having that two thick layer of fur, and it predator and prey are unable to see it. It predator and prey are unable to see it. So these are the adaptation having that polar bear. So that's why the polar bear it can easily survive in that conditions, you know. And next to another one animal is well known animal is a penguin. Okay, wow. So it's also white and is made swell with that white background. Okay, wow. See the figure, the 7.4, you know. So like the white background, it also has a thick skin and lot of fat to protect it from cold. So these penguins also having that thick fur like that polar bear. Okay, so these penguin have the thick fur. Okay, but thick fur, it's also has a thick skin and lot of fat to protect it from cold. And you have seen the picture of penguin is a huddle together. This is they do to keep warm. Recall how warm you feel when you are in hall full of people, you know. You know why that these animals only it can survive in that condition means, because it's very important point, because that body, you know, one word, adaptation. Okay, naturally like the polar bear as well as the penguin having that thick fur. Okay, well, so that's why this animal it can survive in that regions. Okay. And some animals also living in that areas. Okay, wow. Like the polar bears, penguin are also good swimmer. These bodies are streamlined and the feet have webs making them good swimmers. So like the feet, like the padam, you know. So the penguin also good swimmer. These bodies are streamlined. These body are the streamlined meant like the body safe. Okay, wow. Streamlined and the feet have webs. Feet have webs webs making them good swimmer. Another animals living in the polar regions of many types of fishes, musk ocean, reindeer, fox, eels, wolves, etc. etc. It's to be noted that wild fish can remain under cold water for long. Okay, wow. While fish can remain under the cold water for long, birds must remain warm to survive. Because the fish, you know, the fish remain under cold water. The fish enga mabdi poina the cold region ke pogudu. Cold water for long, birds must remain warm to survive. Birds la enga varudna thilippi the birds must remain warm to survive. Adu konjam veduvadu panni adu survive panni. The migrate to warmer region while winter set in. You know, migrate mean that animals, it can move from one place to another place for the different purpose. Like that, first one is adaptations and food and reproduction. In so many reasons also is there. So that's why that animals, it can move from place to place, so that is called that migrate. They migrate to warmer regions when winter set in. They come back after the winter is over. Okay, wow. Cold ku poichna thilippi eppa adutha winter start avu appa marubadi vandhukku. You know, the probably that India is one of the destinations of many of these birds. You must have seen, heard about the Siberian crane that comes from the Siberia to place like is a Bhatrapur in Rajasthan and Sultanpur in Haryana. Okay, because the some birds, they will started the migrate process for food and reproduction and climate condition itself. Okay, like one birds, you know, the Siberian crane that comes from Siberia to place like is Bhatrapur in Rajasthan and Sultanpur in Haryana. And some is a wetland of northeast and some other part of India. Okay, again some other part also having that cold regions. Okay, thank you students. The next class we will discuss about the tropical rainforest. Thank you.